r/AskReddit. What are the best power moves you've ever seen someone do in real life? One of my friend's daughters has hearing aids. They're similar to the ones old people use, but with an extra piece on them. They're not the ones that are attached to your head. If someone is bothering her and she doesn't want to deal with them, she pulls her hearing aids out and keeps doing whatever she was doing. This girl is 8. Had a friend walk up to a girl at a party and say, "You are the hottest girl here and I am the best looking guy. We belong together." He took her home and they are married now. She was the hottest girl there. It's debatable on him. Was at a Mexican restaurant on Cinco de Mayo. Place was absolutely packed. Yet somehow there were only like 2, maybe 3 waiters on staff. We'd been there like 40 minutes and had drinks, but still hadn't gotten to order food. This dude at the next table stands up, starts taking people's orders and delivering them to the kitchen. The other waiters seemed like they really appreciated it, because people were starting to get pissed until that point. He didn't take my table's order, but he took one nearby and he sounded pretty fun. A friend ran into him a few months ago and said he's really cool. My boyfriend's 5-year-old niece was sitting on my lap. Her 7-year-old brother wanted to sit on my lap. So she farted on me and was like, "Guess you'll have to sit in my fart cloud. Now." This fucking guy. TLDR is this game show is essentially the prisoner's dilemma, where two people either cooperate to keep a split of money, or try to backstab the other person for all the money. But if they both backstab, they both lose. This guy pulls an absolute power play that was never done on the show before. At a bar. Not particularly busy. Bartender was talking to some girl across bar, ignoring everybody else who was trying to get drinks. 10 minutes go by. Still chatting. Guy reaches across bar and fills himself up from tap. I asked my friend's 3-year-old son who his new girlfriend was. He said it was my girlfriend. I was at a party in college. One of my friends was chatting up some girl he was into. Another one of our friends went up and pants him. Pants and boxers. My dude didn't freak out or break conversation flow. He just stood there daffy ducking with zero fucks given. And that man got laid that night. It's gotta be that guy who moved the whole battleship to get the sun out of his tired eyes. John Muirney's story about his dad driving to McDonald's with a car full of kids and order one black coffee. Two people clearly on a first date. Dude went for a shit straight after they sat down. A friend and I were driving home after a night out. And we get pulled over by the police for speeding. The cop approaches our vehicle. And my friend, the driver, says to the cop, "I didn't even see you. Where were you parked?" The cop responds by saying he was parked at the bottom of an apartment building driveway that has a blind spot. My friend says to the cop, "Well, I own that building. It's private property. And I've asked you guys numerous times not to park there as I don't want my building having a reputation of being a speed trap." A couple of minutes later, after the cop verifies the information, he comes to the car, apologizes, and sends us on our way. There was a post yesterday where somebody was at a party with Jeff Goldblum. When the host introduced JG to them, JG said, "My God, of course." Like he had heard of the person. They were on cloud 9. Until they heard JG say that to everyone he was introduced to. Oh. Yes. My father told me this story. He had a friend that took philosophy class and they were discussing authority. The teacher made an example. "If I say, the class is over, you can leave. You will do it. But if Mark says the same thing, you will stay here." After that, Mark stood up and said the class was over, they could leave, and every student left the room. My father didn't have a lecture at that time, and when he asked his friend why he wasn't in his philosophy class, he told him this story. I was meeting up with my friends at the bar. They had all been there for a while and comprised about 90% of the bar's business. When I walked in, the hostess decided I was going to be the first one charged a cover fee for entry. I told her I wasn't there for their event and just wanted to sit with my friends already at the bar. She told me tough luck basically and that I would have to pay. I yelled over to my friends she wouldn't let me in without paying, and they all just stood up and left so we could go to our favorite bar instead. was only like a $5 or $10 DOTA cover. And instead of getting it, they lost the majority of their current business, about 7 people total. All of whom drink more than they should. My friends made me look like a boss. But it wouldn't have been a power move without them. I'm lucky to have a great group that has each other's back. This is from back in HS in the 90s. I had a friend that was really small who would get picked on often but never did anything about it. Neither did the rest of us when we got picked on. Nothing ever got physical, so who cares? Why start a fight? Use your words. Not your fists. Etc. One day, we were talking and a big dude that was in his grade grabbed him in a chokehold out of nowhere. No reason at all. My buddy kicked one leg forward and all of a sudden, the big dude was on his back and pinned. My buddy had him by the throat. He said, "Will you stop it now?" The big guy did. Never bugged him again. It so happens that the little guy's dad taught Shotokan and he was absurdly good. I've never seen someone move so fast. Took down a guy that was 75 pounds heavier than him easy. Apparently he helped his dad train students. He'd never brought it up before as it wasn't important to him. Girls and cars were more interesting at the time to us. Years ago, a buddy and stopped in one of the national chain restaurants open 24 hours. Usually the service was pretty decent. Not sure what happened that time. Was a number of people in a kind of addition room off the main area. Got our food and first round of drinks. Buddy wanted a coffee refill. They didn't leave us the carafe like some do now. No waitress, nobody checked in the room for a while. Heard other people commenting they wanted more coffee as well. I got up, walked to some little station off the kitchen maybe? Been a while. Grabbed a pot of coffee and walked back to the room. Poured my buddy's coffee and then poured everybody else who wanted it. Got some laughing thank yous. It was a small thing but funny as fuck to me. Driving somewhere with my brother in the middle of the night. Stop at the gas station. Kid runs up to the car as we're going to drive away. My brother rolls down the window. Kid asks my brother to buy him smokes. My brother tells him straight to fuck off. Kid tells my brother to fuck off for disrespecting him. And that he best drive off like a bitch or him and his buddies will beat us like the pussies we are. Some shit like that. Rolls. My brother says some shit like, "Oh sorry sir. I guess I need my buddies then." And flashes his badge at the kid. Kid's eyes went huge and he ran. Thanks to you, Penelope Peril. Roll not roll. Probably in class. We know how when you ask if you can use the bathroom. Teachers are like, "Can you?" Comma. Well, one classmate when he asked and our teacher said that. Was like, "Yes I can," and just left. My old company required a doctor's note if you missed 3 days sick. We also had a PTO system, meaning that our sick time and vacation were the same. On the third day I called my boss and told them I wasn't feeling better. They asked me to email them a doctor's note. I told them I didn't go to the doctors, it was a flu, you just have to wait it out. Basically the VP that required I get to note or come in. So I came in. In my PJs, clocked in, filled out the PTO request for the rest of the week. Puked in my waist basic. Which started a sympathy pukes and was sent home for the day, because guess what, I was sick. It might not be the biggest of all the power moves. But I always appreciate it when somebody shows up late drinking an iced coffee. If it was a regular coffee, you could assume that they got the cup a while ago and are still carrying it. When you hear those ice cubes rattling around in the cup though, you know for sure that they got that drink pretty recently even though they were running late. It's a real say something move. I once watched a guy eat a pencil because someone offered it to him for lunch. He had something to eat. But he still ate the pencil. My first boyfriend and I were out at a restaurant in the middle of the week. It was nearly empty. But for some reason the hostess sat us across from the only other couple. We were 18 and the couple was about 30. The guy was talking at length about his boring ass job and the lady was obviously not into it. He was talking so loud that we, me and my boyfriend, couldn't even have our own conversation. The guy finally shut up and there was an extended silence. After a bit, my BF looked up at me and said, "So, do you put out?" I busted out laughing and the woman at the other table hastily covered her grin. The dude scoffs and says, "Good one, buddy," and threw his napkin down like he lost an argument or something. I'm not a man. So I don't know what kind of power play that was. But I will never forget it. Had a friend who worked as a fellow HVAC tech in Dallas. He had problems with this restaurant towing him while he was parked at his GF's place. She lived upstairs and she had two parking spaces with her condo. He got towed one too many times, so he had a source for the odorant they use in natural gas, and he put a few drops near the outdoor seating area and waited. Sure enough, the fire dept came and shut the restaurant down for a weekend while they investigated. Then he started parking at a pay lot two blocks away, and he started towing the restaurant patrons' cars when they parked in his GF's assigned parking. Cops got involved and the cops took his side. He was later able to get a group of condo owners together and go after that restaurant for having them towed from the spots that they actually owned. They were able to get their liquor license suspended for 180 days. It put them out of business. This is something that I did myself, and it isn't even that great of a story, but I want to tell it. One time I was at a bar with this girl I was hanging out with along with some other friends. There were six of us in total. At some point, the girl's ex walks in and comes over to our table to make awkward conversation. The girl was clearly uncomfortable and so was everyone else. So I go to the bar and order six shots and bring them back to the table. I hand a shot to each person in my group and hold mine out for a toast. The girl's ex got the hint and left us alone. It wasn't so much a power move as much as it was just a sheer lack of fucks to give. I was taking a test in high school when I noticed someone else in the class shuffling through his backpack. Without saying a word, he pulled out a newspaper. Kicked back just to read the paper instead of taking his test. It was so simple but effective. In his own way, he calmly erased the serious atmosphere our teacher was trying to instill. In grade 4, a kid in my class asked to use the bathroom, and the teacher said something along the lines of, "Too many people have gone already. You'll have to wait." Little guy pissed on the floor right in front of the teacher. Not me, but a coworker. She's in court and arguing with the opposing counsel about some settlement, and gives them the "take it or I walk" speech, and they refuse. As she is making the power walk out of the courtroom, her high heel shoe slips off her foot. Without missing a beat, tripping, or even turning her head, she tells her assistant who was walking out with her, "Get that," and kept walking. Poker night at a friend's house. $40 buy-in, winner takes all, unless the last two people decide to split it, with 8 people playing. By the time it got down to 3 people, we had been playing for almost 5 hours already. I wanted to go home and had the most chips. So I said, "Let's split it between us 3. I have the most chips. It'll take 40% and you 2 take 30% each." They both said no. I asked the same question 4 times in the next hour, but my chips went down a lot by then. It got down to me and another person. Everyone knew I wanted to go home because it was late. This other guy looks at me and says, "We can stay here forever playing, just the two of us. Let's split a 50/50 and call it a night." Everyone was like, "Okay. Seems fair." I took one look at my chips and said no. 70/30, and everyone was like, "What?" He actually caved and I went home with over 200 bucks. When getting a ride with friends, inform the person driving that the child lock on their door is on. They will get out and open the door for you, and when you get out, don't acknowledge them or shut the door. To anyone watching, it will look like they are your chauffeur. Where's that story about the SR-71 fighter jet pilot checking his speed with the airport control tower that comes up every so often on Reddit? Keep an awkward silence. So after law school, I was an intern while waiting for bar results. One day I had to call this notoriously shitty opposing counsel to make a settlement offer. He was a complete asshole to me on the phone and refused to take my offer to his client, which is against the law. When I told him that, he demanded to know what law, which is unbelievably ridiculous. As I was calmly retrieving that law citation, he asked me if I was an attorney. This was literally the day before the bar exam results came out. I had no idea if I passed, but I responded, "No, but I will be tomorrow." He then hung up on me, and when my supervisor called him, he said he refused to speak to anyone that wasn't an attorney. Next day, I got my results and I passed. I immediately submitted my registration with the state bar to get my license number. And I was in ahead of everyone else for some reason. So I got it super fast. I had someone in my office swear me in instead of waiting for the ceremony. And 1 week after that guy hung up on me. I wrote him a letter with the same offer. Signed SICKAPOTSQ. Junior year of high school. AP physics class. It's the end of the year. AP tests are over. We have nothing left to do. So our teacher is leading a game of scientist hangman. The puzzle on the board is NRN. The classroom door is open. There's a senior walking down the hallway past the classroom. He takes one glance at the puzzle and yells Daniel Bernoulli without breaking stride. When my sister and I were little, like 7 and 9, my sister saved her allowance money to buy that Shaggy CD with the then popular hit Wasn't Me on it. We were in the car and my sister put the CD in. My mom listens to about 50 seconds of the song, ejects the CD, and swiftly tossed it out the window of the moving car without saying one word. Edit. Guys, my mom had been on a long road trip with two annoying kids. In an era long before iPods. She was at the end of her rope. She's not a dick, lol. My first job was writing for a small newspaper and I had to interview a local guy who had written a book on negotiation strategies for everyday life. We grabbed lunch at a small cafe. He talked and I asked questions and took notes. When we were done, he goes, "Thanks for lunch," stands up, and walks out. The man knew his craft. I saw a comment on a post the other day saying that a guy took his donger out in a public bathroom then decided which urinal to go to. My 3-year-old nephew came up to me and said, "Uncle, do you wanna hear a joke?" I responded in my best world weary voice with, "Kiddo, my whole life is a joke." And without missing a beat, the little shit replies, "Okay, but this is a funny one. Love that kid." Edit. My first gold. Thank you. This kid from my class in high school was too late for physics class. When he entered the class, the teacher said, "When you are too late, you know you are not supposed to enter that door. Jacob." So, this happened on a summer day, and the fire exit door was open. After 10 minutes, we hear this walking sound on the metal steps of the emergency stairs outside. We had class in room 403. The fourth floor. After a while, we all see Jacob entering the room from the fire exit like nothing happened and sit down. Dropped my son at preschool early with breakfast. Only other kids there was a girl eating her breakfast at one end of the table. She bats her eyes and says, "You can sit by me." He says, "I like this seat over here." At the other end of the table. And she got up and moved. I worked at a grocery store with a friend of mine and he wanted a long weekend because he had friends coming into town, so I took over his days for him. Everything was fine. I was still under 40 hours and the days were covered. Although for some reason the store manager was upset about this and was lecturing us about switching days. My friend looked at him in the middle of his rant and said, "Bob, your beard looks great today. We're both straight dudes." He immediately started cracking up and walked away. That was the end of that and there were no talks about switching days after that. When I got fired at my old job, I didn't know they were going to fire me then. They pulled me into a conference room. There was 3 people and me, and the 3 were sitting around the table. One said to me, "Have a seat." I said no and stood while they all talked up at me. I'm glad I went out that way because apparently I was the talk of the company for a few days until the next person quit. It was a super shitty company. If you want to get nothing in return, you can like and join my Discord. There is a link in the description.